There's the one. I couldn't tell you what's the difference in that and the other side. That's where I'm at.
Yeah.
That must feel such a different angle than this way. That's absolutely mental.
Well, I just want to know where it's going so wrong.
Yeah.
And I've had, as I say, stack and tilt, then I've got some figure of eight golf swing, and I just in the end I blew
figure
up.
Figure of eight?
Oh yeah, because like, oh, yeah, he said, you're tall, should be up there. And, oh, I said, you go swing a figure eight. I just walked out.
You've like, not been on Robo swing, have you?
No. So <That's laughs> I was kind of frazzled. That's what it's got to. And I think what my son, he's training to be a pro as well.
Oh, yeah.
He's working at the shop at 10 at the moment, but the pro's giving letters saying, so I want to take you on as assistant. But he's gone a little bit perfect
I've
swing.
Gone too far with the technical stuff. Hair in the swing.
He's
not
enjoying
it.
So
I
said,
what do you play off?
12, 13.
Yeah, 13. Yeah.
What's struck a chord with me is that, like, I saw your lesson with Ralph, the Welsh guy, right?
Yeah.
It's a bit of a, it's a funny lesson, but it's really good. But what sort of got me is, yeah, like, I'm a practical sort of guy, but it's like, I could skim a stone very efficiently, I could kick a ball into the right hand corner of the field. So when you put that in my hand, am I like a dick? So, it's simple, isn't it? You know, all the equipment's easier to hit than it ever was.
Yeah, yeah. So, it sounds like that about one of
them. So that's the way I feel about it. So that's, you've got my history. All I could ever hit was a draw.
Right.
Now I haven't got a draw. I've got fat thin.
Yeah. Mainly a weak cut, isn't it?
Weak cut, sky, you know, I've got the full back. I had the shanks for ages, didn't I? I had all the extension going on, I was shanking everything.
That was the worst period.
That's the one really went bad. And I haven't got the temperament, if I'm honest, to be actually doing that. I don't expect to go out and shoot, you know, level golf, but I'm enjoying hit the ball again.
So you've been on a virtual roller coaster.
Oh, 2.5 is a complete Two and a half is absolute I haven't enjoyed it, don't want to do it. I do it because he got me back into it really. So
the amount of times I've heard you say, I'm giving this up and the next week we're back out on the course.
I found it easier boxing, if I'm honest. You just look a tool. You know when you used to play golf and you go out and I say, to Ryan, don't worry, just play, you play bad. I said, just look around the course, mate. There's always someone worse. I feel like I'm
Yeah, in our group you are.
Yeah, that's it. From being up there, I've gone, that's it.
Oh.
That's what's happened, mate. So.
How the mighty have fallen.
Yeah.
It's kind of, but it's still there in the system somewhere.
So a few swings on there first, Paul, just to get yourself.
Still put.
86.8 to bed speed.
That's a decent one, but it's pulley.
Yeah, pull draw.
Yeah. I just don't feel I get the into it anymore. That's my pull draw cut. Told you about every shot, boys.
You have.
It goes back to me, is like when you box, you punch from your boots.
Yeah.
And you sort of talk that.
Yeah.
And I said, I don't feel none of that anymore, and I used to feel very, you know, sort of dynamic that way, but I've sort of lost that, and I don't think it's, you can do speed and movement as you get older, but I certainly
not to that extent.
No, exactly. I was always thought was effortless power, but then I've had powerful effort now, and it's gone anywhere.
Yeah.
Anywhere,
sort of. Yeah.
See, I've got different flights, different shapes.
Yeah, I mean, it's not picked up your club head speed every time. But
yeah.
You've gone from 73 club head speed to 84.
Thank you.
And then your carry distances are all over.
Exactly. So I can be
picking the club up, and you're like, you don't know if you're going to go over the back of the green.
He did tell you sometimes, okay, and you go, have you hit that? I have 220.
Is that four iron the other day? Was
out of the rough, yeah, like I can hit an absolute bomb, and you just go, where's that? I go, damn it.
As soon as you hit it, you're thinking,
yeah.
Oh no.
Yeah. And then I get the one I'm confident that I'm going to carry it, and it just goes plop. Oh, there's the one. I couldn't tell you what's the difference in that and the other side. That's where I'm at.
Yeah.
94.3 per base speed, that one. That last one.
Yeah?
But it was a shank.
It's very easy. I tell you what.
The club head path going so far left.
Yeah. So that's why I shaked it, because I knew it was probably just little. Subconsciously.
So that number was brilliant.
Yeah.
There's 6 degrees of freedom, but these are the three that we're picking out. We're picking out
the horizontal.
Yeah.
That goes so left and right, not just that way.
Yeah.
Rotation, which is torque.
Yeah.
Yeah. And vertical force.
Right.
So when you push down, you get the equal opposite force up. Yeah.
Yeah.
So every movement you make, generally, especially in golf, is a combination of all three. Golf's a primitive action.
Yeah.
Like any throwing, hitting. So you start. So this is like when we start to be more instinctive and think less, we start to play better. It's, it's an inherent evolutionary movement we've got with this in our hands.
Yeah.
But often it's the thinking that starts to inhibit that process, so it becomes less primitive, less primal, and more kind of mechanical. And
which is why the paralysis by analysis.
Exactly, and so you start, and it shows up on the way that you start shifting your forces as well, which we'll see in a bit. This, by the way, isn't driven from movement to intention. It's very much influenced from intention to movement. Movement's born out of intention.
If you intend to kick the ball to the right hand side of the field, you'd do it, wouldn't
there's
you?
No mechanics in your mind.
You just do it.
So these are the fundamental forces we're talking about. So I'm looking at how are you creating these, when you're creating them, in what magnitude, the timing. I want you to look at that line.
Yeah.
This angle.
Yeah, you want it retained, don't you?
Well, you're going to see what happens. I just want to see here what happens. Just doesn't really rotate much more.
That's to explain it. I walk off after 18, I was like, yeah, that's all sore and muscle down. You know,
you're getting it all from your thoracic.
Yeah, that's where it's coming from.
What we're going to do is we're going to see what happens when we give the body an experience of torque in both directions. Start to harmonise that with the weight of the golf club. So your body's working with the centre of mass of the club, and it's going to start to time the torque.
Yeah.
And we're going to explore the footprint, see how the ankles want to move to create that.
Yeah.
So you're going to start it. So we're going to start to feel movement from the ground up.
Yeah.
And see how the rest of the body reacts.
Well, this is something I haven't ever been taught about the ground. I think I did it when I first started, but it's been coached out of me.
Yeah.
And now I don't stand it with any real thought, if I'm honest. I can't, because if I do, I'm gripping it like that.
And Ryan's the next generation of this, because Ryan, this is a coached golf swing. What you've done is you've chunked movement.
Yeah.
Okay, and it shows in the pressure traits. Body's trying to do its best. The body's always trying to do its best. It never lets us down.
Yeah.
It's us who let the body down.
Whether it's in
health and well-being or whatever part of your life, it's us who let the body down.
One of the very first lessons I had, and he said to me, "You're coming off it in the backswing." Well, I don't think I was coming off it. What I think I was doing, I just had this huge turn and had a huge load. And he stopped all of that. And that was the start of the decline. Yeah. Because I then got in this thing. Of course, when he's there standing over, you're hitting straighter shots. And they were more control shots, but I always judge my golf on that, how far I could hit it.
So you want to hit some, you want to throw this.
Yeah.
You want to hit something, you want to throw a ball, what do I do?
Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Don't go.
No, I'm not going to go like that.
You've got to find out what your body wants to do.
Yeah, yeah.
So your body might want to stay more centered in golfing terms, and your body might want to sway more. We want to make this the origin.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. So your origin at the moment, you've shifted your origin of where you're moving.
Yeah.
What drives your movement?
Yeah.
And that's really important. Where is the origin of the movement?
Yeah.
So where's your driver?
Yeah.
Are you driving it from, am I moving that club because I'm thinking of my hands, my arm, my shoulder? Because now you're driving body movement from this particular part. So you picked out one variable of the system and you've amplified that and you've gone, that's where I need to move.
The thought process might realize that's probably more where you're at, whereas I just stand there and think.
Yeah, because you've gone past that. You went up to
it. Because I can't think like technical like that. I've just got to think, give me some, as you say, primal movement, something like a do.
That's all it is. Take your club in your hand.
Yes.
In fact, just your right hand, and just start to make some half swings in the air, twisting the disc to make a swing. So straight away, can you see it's gone to his arm? So you've gone to make it from the upper body.
Yeah, yeah. You just want to go like that, don't you?
And let your body rotate with it. And so there's a timing that starts to emerge.
My hips feel absolutely mental now. It's as if I'm just going. that hasn't been happening, has it, obviously?
Raving.
Back in the 80s. It just feels, you know what it is? It just feels, and when you have a lesson, you don't feel loose. That feels loose, which is not in a bad way.
It's taking you the way.
Yeah, I've gone from being like, throttling the thing and then trying to release a tension and all of that. It's just like,
when you're trying to make a movement, when you
get
to base, it's a form of manipulation. So
rather than just a natural.
Rather than something reactive, Now pop both hands on and just let's feel the same flow. So there's a snap at the bottom on the way through, and on the way back, right at the bottom, feel that. That's it, use the feet to create the speed for the snap. Just let the club just swish past the body, use that, the weight of the club head, that's it. What are you feeling there?
Just a lot more movement, you know, there, and a lot freer, in the sense that I'm not thinking of the arms, it just follows. Yeah, the arms are just coming with the body, isn't it?
Exactly, those forces.
Just going like that.
And the ankles are now involved, because the feet are moving. If you pop on the plate for me,
yeah.
The ankle's doing virtually nothing at the minute.
Yeah.
But as soon as you introduce the friction from the ground, now it's working.
Yeah, yeah.
And so this gives you that rotation from the hips and the lower back.
Yeah, because if you locked your ankles, you wouldn't be able to do that, would you? Yeah.
But then the feet are able to move as well. So
yeah, freely.
Yeah, exactly. So you, and then now, this here, this momentum, say to move this, say stick.
Yeah.
It could either come from here.
Yeah.
Or
the body.
It can come from the body.
Yeah.
You can imagine that's probably not going to be as controllable.
Yes. As something following the body line. Yeah.
Then as soon as you start to move, you start to get more and more stretch, which is just pulling the whole chain.
Yeah. You know what I can feel as well, the weight of the club.
Right.
Which I've never felt the weight of.
Right.
They always used to say to me, you've got to really have some heavy clubs, heavy shots, and I don't feel the weight of it anyway. I've never felt the weight of the club in my golf swing. It's kind of lock, isn't it? That's what it feels like.
It's so interesting you just said lock and unlock, because that's what the foot does.
Yeah.
So when your foot goes back, it locks, and when it goes forward, it unlocks.
Yeah.
The space in between the joints closes as your foot locks, and then as you go back, it unlocks.
Well, that's what it feels like.
And then it'll lock again as you push up.
It just feels like keying a lock. That's what it feels like.
Just raise this knee up and put your foot on the floor. So that's it. And now I want you to rotate your hips that way. And that's essentially what most people do, but I want you to come back again. Now we're going to use the floor. That's it. And it loads and shifts your weight.
Yeah.
So you've got pressure going this way,
into
the floor, to rotate that.
This is allowed to drive on the cam.
Yeah. That's how we rotate the body.
Yeah.
All it's doing is it's just awakening in a chain.
Yeah.
Because your body's probably never done this.
Yeah.
So it's like suddenly repatterning, and the body starts to feel the force through the body, through the leg and through the torso, and notice it rotates your chest with it. Everything gets pulled.
You can feel it there. You really feel it there, can't you? When you do it.
It's so different. Good. So we'll get up off the floor, and then we go back to this. And now without the club, just do your Elvis moves.
Yeah.
Yeah, just bang the board back and forth. That's it.
Every point I can feel that club now. I would never feel it. Seriously. You could have given me a scaffold pole with 7-9 And do you know what the funny thing is as well? This is all the conflicting information, the shit you carry in your head. Because I was early extending. Oh no, you've got to imagine that you're sitting with your back against the bar, they said, keep the bum there. So the bum ain't there when you're doing that, is it? You have to extend to create the movement, because when you're so static like that, and they say no, because what you're doing is you're going that way, but what I was getting was extension without the rotation.
Just look what happens to my left foot.
Yeah. Yeah.
So look at my pressure.
Yeah.
It's not doing this, look.
No, it's gone down and forward.
It's not doing this.
Yeah.
It's doing this, it's going to the target.
Yeah.
So I'm going that way,
bang. I go back and give that
back. Because the feet.
Because it's doing it, the forces are working downwards rather than me having to do this one. But him telling me to be static there.
But what happens actually is
it's made it worse.
So when you push, force vector, you've got vectors doing this.
Yeah.
Which rotate.
Yeah.
When you're like this.
Yeah. Yeah.
Pushing.
Yeah.
Off of that blue green.
It actually feels, Marcus, my knee is shooting out.
Yeah, does it?
Absolutely low. But look where we've gone from.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Have a few shots.
Find that mental.
Different feel?
Yeah, I've got to say it was an absolutely s*** ball, but it felt lovely.
Yeah, it looked beautiful. Do you know where you need to be? Yeah. You need to be in the place where you just haven't got a clue where this is pointing, but it just kind of feels right.
Okay.
And I'm moving into posture, and this feels right.
Yeah.
Because that's what you're doing. You go, I'm just going to swing.
Yeah.
Your body's using this process.
Okay.
The body has to go where it wants to let the energy flow. So move it around in your grip. Feel the sweet spot, point at the target. Where's the sweet spot of the golf club? Don't look down, just feet now, just yes it, let it rest and point it where you want it to go.
Well, that was it.
Right, okay, hold it.
Yeah.
Okay, have a look.
That's pretty good, actually, yeah. That's like that tree, what's your eyes imagine? You know, the little tree in there, in the background.
Now, oh, sorry. Use your normal setup.
Yeah.
That's it, line it up, just look where you're going. What you'd normally feel comfortable doing.
Yeah, that bit.
Let go.
The left of this. The left. The left of the tree, yeah. I mean, that must be shocking with a driver.
Well, the thing is that if you think that's square,
yeah.
Okay, that's visual alignment for you.
Yeah.
If you think that's square,
yeah.
Okay, the thing is it's short, and you've associated that as square. As
yeah.
Okay, now when you create all these extra torques and when you start creating more free flowing and this thing's rotating,
yeah.
It's kind of, you've got to start somehow
guiding
this to the target.
You're
probably putting tension at the end of the chain.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's not free.
This is not suddenly this.
Yeah.
It's suddenly, you've got to suddenly try and
redirect it.
Because when you pick this thing up, okay, your body knows where it is.
Yeah.
I didn't miss it.
No.
Okay, that same way with the knife and fork, you don't miss your mouth.
Yeah.
Your body uses its GPS. You're allowing your body to use its natural GPS.
Yeah.
It's proprioception. Yeah. You start looking down and the body might not want to put the club there. Take your grip by looking where you want to go. And now take your stance looking where you're going.
Yeah.
So look out there. Good. And then now you can use your momentum.
Now
there's shot.
That was perfect.
Yeah. It feels absolutely f***ing mental, mate. So we're going to go with it.
Bang forward. Now bang back. Yes.
Yeah, it's like reprogramming yourself. I tell you, it's really strange.
Just out the arms and the weight of the club just reacts to you.
And how they feel like, yeah. Doesn't
now
feel
just,
like.
No, exactly. So I can take that away. Yeah. That's awesome. That must feel such a different angle.
It feels absolutely mental.
I'm glad I came, but I don't think you're going to have this trouble, Ryze.
No, sorry, Ryze. You're going to get the.
I think obviously I'm just.
He needed it more than I did.
Brilliant.
Sure.
Yeah, nice.
Yeah, look at that now. Got that starting right. A lot further right. That's a place, this I would assume this is space you would never even think of swinging.
As I say, my biggest difficulty is I taught myself to draw the ball, right, the way I did it might have been wrong with the ball above my feet because I didn't want to be a slicer. And every time I had to go on the golf course, I had to go left hand side of the tee, aim up that side and give myself the fairway to work. But
right.
I would hit that shot. So I now stand in the middle of a tee, myself, going, is this going left, right, top or fat of the driver? That's
why, yeah.
Because I don't know where.
And trying to swing straight.
And I took the natural out of my swing, which was probably a lot more arm rotation, a lot more hip rotation, like what you're showing me now.
Yeah.
Because people used to say there was too many moving parts in there.
Right.
That's what I was told.
Yeah.
You know, I'm only telling you the truth. So, but in effect, it wasn't.
No.
It was. So,
everything
I'm not
moves.
Saying it's as good as what we're doing now, but
no.
It was somewhere near that. I could go out and play with it.
Everything moves, just some parts move less or more than others.
Yeah.
You've got to let the body decide.
Shot.
Yeah, nice.
Feel different?
Ah, oh, lovely, isn't it?
Just feel.
What's the numbers on those ones? And they're not flat out, are
they? No, they're not. 166 carry, 77.5 mile an hour club head speed.
Yeah. Which I know I can get that in the mid 80s and high end 80s.
But you know, if you want more club head speed, you don't go for more brew.
No,
force.
You go for more movement.
You just speed the tempo up.
More
force from the ground. So you know the banging of the board.
Yeah.
Well, I'm talking about.
I've got that board at home. I've got plenty of 4.56 in the deal, haven't I?
He's not going to like it.
Yeah.
and that can feel.
Yeah. A lot higher,
yeah,
haven't they? And obviously playing it off the front foot as you're doing that as well.
It's neutralising your shape, isn't it?
You all right?
176
carry. Yeah.
And your club head speed went up to 85.6.
Yeah, because it was around 88, 89 at my peak.
But so and you were using your feet.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
A lot more
it doesn't feel as if I'm brutalising.
No, you're not.
No, it doesn't look like it.
Looks smooth, doesn't it?
Yeah,
I suppose you know what it normally looks like, so it looked different.
Yeah, definitely, yeah.
Shot.
Beautiful. That's the best one, surely. It's awesome. Mate. Yeah, that's a great shot. That.
One, six, two, 90.8 club head speed.
Yeah, it was a little bit off the bottom, if I'm honest.
Is it?
Well, that's a good speed for a 7,
isn't
it?
Yeah,
very good.
But more importantly,
yeah,
it looks smoother, would you say, right?
Yeah, definitely.
The old boy could be coming back.
I mean, yeah. He's making a comeback. That's it. Look at where you're going. As you're feeling the weight of the club, like waggling the club and feeling, that's it. It just looks like it's going to be a good shot before he plays.
Yeah.
Makes the swing.
Yeah.
Shot.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
So see the repetition without repetition.
Yeah. It's beautiful of Marcus to be on the right hand side. And no, it's not. Going sideways.
180 yard carry, 90 mile an hour club head speed, so it's starting to repeat.
And that's not
repeat
out the middle yet, I'll tell you that.
No.
But it doesn't look like you're trying to achieve the 90 mile per hour.
Your smash was 1.28,
yeah.
So no, it's not.
Oh,
yeah,
oh,
nice.
Oh
that's. Yeah. That's big, guy.
That is awesome.
Shot.
See, I wasn't bugging your boys, was I? You might have thought I saw
that. No,
look at your smash, 1.45.
Yeah.
Your club head speed was 780, so
yeah,
you dropped it a bit.
Yeah.
But 178 carry.
Yeah.
You're happy with that, aren't you?
Yeah, yeah.
It's a big carry with 7 like that.
Yeah,
it is.
Yeah.
To get you out of that senior flex now, eh, Paul?
Yeah. Oi, 3 years I'll be in the senior.
I can tell what them boys on a Wednesday are going to start to swim on. The Wednesday morning has now changed.
Oh, look at this. It's like
it's
like a robo swing.
Yeah.
Nice.
Robocop.
Right, better get the young man in.
Yeah.
We can do forward.
So 166 carry.
Yeah,
very good.
I know that's an easy swing for me, and I'm happy with that. I
feel
go
different.
Oh yeah, feels just loose as a goose. Mate.
Awesome.
Just feels.
And it can't feel loose as a goose if the forces aren't there for the
no,
arms.
No, because
it's
just,
if this
is all like that, it's going to feel tight and constricted, isn't it? It's got to.
And the forces have come through, transferred through the pelvis. Pelvis accelerates it through to everything else.
It just shows you when my chipping's got so. With the staticness of my chip shot,
you see the chipping and pitching is just a minor version.
Yeah,
of it.
Just a smaller version.
Yeah.
Obviously,
yeah.
So you've still got a movement.
Exactly.
You've got
momentum. What are you doing when you're moving? If you're moving with it, your body's moving. If you're going to throw a ball, you don't just stand there and do this.
Yeah.
You move with it. So every joint is involved in this momentum, and that's signalling. You get proprioceptive feedback from every joint. So when you move everything, your body's getting a bigger stimulus.
Yeah.
So it's starting to get a much more heightened awareness of the pattern of the movement you're making, and it can refine it then better.
Yeah.
Whereas I don't really have much affinity for this. I don't really know what. I don't know how far that's going to throw it. But as soon as I start to include more joints, you get more control.
Yeah.
Awesome. Well done.
Yeah.
Nicely done, Paul.
Yeah.
Happy with that.
Yeah. The simplest thing that you teach is the movement or the freedom of movement, whereas a lot of other teaching is just about position.
Yeah.
So position.
Right. I've not said position once.
No,
I?
Exactly. And a position doesn't give you a freedom. I've always
well,
said to
exactly
Ryan, I said
swing,
it's called a golf swing for
exactly
a reason. You have to swing the thing.
Yeah.
But I said it's not about moving different parts, is it? Because that's not freedom of movement, is it?
And a position is a snapshot in time of that motion.
Yeah. Which
so
something, let's be honest, takes what, about a second and a half? So how can you attain and tune your brain to a position?
And that's what mine's been. Is,
yeah, exactly.
Oh, get in this position.
Yeah.
And it looks all right.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, it looks like.
Looks great.
It does look category one every day of the week.
Yeah. And it just doesn't work because the movements aren't there.
Right, come on.
Let's get it all fused together. So, do you want to hit a few shots, Ryan? And thanks for waiting, mate.
That's all right.